So good day everyone. So this is my PowerPoint presentation showing Patiño. The visual indicator showing that the cargo has a high moisture content during cargo loading operation. So who declared the moisture content of the cargo? So the declaration of moisture content shall contain or be accompanied by a statement by the shipper that the moisture content is the best of his knowledge and belief, the average moisture content of the cargo. The declaration is presented to the master. 4.3. So what happened to the cargo during the voyage? The average moisture content is high and the cargo temperature is during loading. So if the average moisture content of the grain is high and the cargo temperature of the loading is high, the condition of the cargo will eventually start to deteriorate. The cargo may self-heat, go moldy, and or become cake. So why do we need to know the transportable moisture limit of a dry bulk cargo? The insurance of FMP TML certificate is one of the most important tests that us can perform, providing confidence to client that their material is safe to transport via bulk carrying. The FMP is the PowerPoint at which is granular bulk material become fluid. Confidence that material is safe to transport via bulk carrier. What is the maximum of moisture content of the cargo that is considered safe for carriage in ship? So the AMO bulk carrier code referred to above adapts that is known as the transportable moisture limit TML. This is the maximum moisture content of a cargo deemed safe for carriage by sea and ship. Other than specially designed ships, it is defined as 90% of the MFP. So what is the cold maximum moisture content of the cargo, which is considered safe for carriage? The 5 TML is the maximum moisture content considered safe for carriage. So that's all. My presentation. Thank you.